You're a father yourself today, two young girls, right?
Yeah.
And you're not that straight.
Well, I kind of love the silliness, okay? I think there's not enough silliness in the world, so I love all the silly games that children play, and no matter how outrageous they are, you know, the spaghetti can come right off the table, onto the floor, and it's like...
You kind of like it.
Well, I don't kind of like it, but it's just that's what's going on, so, you know.
I know this because...
I mean, I question it, like...
Yeah, well, what
now he's going to make the dinner now. What's going to happen?
The thing is, I know this because you were talking to my researcher here on the phone. And one of your daughters came by and asked, who are you talking to? And you said, this nice Swedish man, you said.
Yeah.
And she said...
Well, no, she got jealous of the fact that I was not giving her...
Yes, that's an explanation, but she called him the stinky pig.
Yeah.
So I have this problem with my researcher now. He's so offended, you know.
There you go. That's my point in case. How can you can't reprimand that because it's so funny, right? Everyone loves that. Yeah. Everyone loves the researchers. It's a stinky piggy. It's fantastic.
Do you ever perform at home? Do you ever perform for your kids?
All the time. Yeah, it's nonstop.
Do you play your own songs, or...?
They don't want to hear my own songs. They don't want to hear my own. They want to hear... I make things up for them, you know. It's just like, what happened today, or, you know, what fun songs that play games and lyrical games with their names, and, you know. I mean, it's just what happens. I can't explain it. Because... I can't believe I'm talking about this. I have a new album.
Yeah, and these songs are not on the album. That's what you want to say.
Definitely not. A lot of the songs have to do with poo.
Yeah. Why didn't you name the album Poo?
That's another album. This one's called Get Up. But I mean, it's just children. You end up reliving your childhood with silliness and silly games. And
do your father ever go to your concert?
Oh yeah, sure. I love that blues song you did. You know.
Actually,
everything else was shit, Dad. That's great.
you are also a very quite celebrated and quite awarded photographer, and you. I mean, not many people know this. Perhaps in Sweden and Norway,
but
well, yeah, you've done a lot. You've done celebrities, other musicians. You've done. You even done a series recently with wounded soldiers.
That's
which
right.
Was very much praised. And I don't know if it's... Is it for you, being Brian Adams, is it an advantage or a disadvantage as a photographer to have that name?
Well, I've never really questioned that. I don't really think that way. So for me, it's just about being creative and making things, so I like creating images because some of them are beautiful, you know, and some of them are arresting and some of them are questioning, revealing. And in the case of the wounded soldiers, I felt it was time to, for me personally, who I have to be quite honest with you, I was not for any of the engagements that happened in Iraq or Afghanistan. And so in a way, this was my way of making a social commentary, a document perhaps that could be reflected upon for many years to come on what happens when you engage in war. And so these guys are coming back. You know, I don't think anybody in Britain particularly expected, because the promise was, oh, we're going to go in and we're going to go out, you know. But it didn't happen that way. And so suddenly, boys were coming back and on the high street and they were in pieces and mothers were pulling their children away from them, you know. So you have to sort of break down that stigma that these people are still people and they have to relive their lives and create them, you know, a new life for themselves and learn again how to walk. So it was quite a moving series of pictures.
You call yourself a portrait photographer.
Yeah.
Do a lot of portraits. What makes an interesting portrait? I mean, if you see, you have four people here. Who would make the most interesting portrait?
Well, it, depending on how you photograph it, everyone's got their interesting sides, you know. And so I would say it would be difficult to choose one person over another, because you can find something in everybody.
You are kind of posing.
Well, I'm sort of, you know, just in case. I mean, like, who would make the most interesting portrait? So many people are quite self-aware.
That was a very, but I do find the young lady very beautiful, and I think, you know, especially with a black and white top like that, that's sensational.
So, yeah, So it's no age before beauty here.
I'm just being honest, mate.
Well, the most important thing is how you look in real life, right?
Yes.
Oh, never mind.
I thought the most important thing was what your soul was like and not at all what you look
like. No, it's only how you look. In the end of the day, it's only how you look, yeah. No. Thank you so much.
We will be judged, you know. We'll be judged.
By our looks?
Yeah, because this is all going on the internet and high def. We're doomed.
this is the problem with modern television.
We're so done.
I know, okay? I know.
How old are you?
I was born in 59, just like you.
Same as me, yeah. So, I mean, forget it. We're just, you know.
Please welcome Bryan Adams.